Hello everyone, my name is Praveen and today I'm going to show you how to create your first ASP.NET MVC application using .NET 6 and Visual Studio 2022. This will be a very good tutorial for the people who are new to ASP.NET MVC. So first you have to install Visual Studio 2022. You can find the link in the description below. I also have a video on that. If you want, you can see that. I will provide the link in the description. So if you want to create your application, first you have to open Visual Studio 2022. So you will see a screen like this and then click on create a new project. So here you can see a lot of templates. So our template is MVC template. So we can search for it like this. So MVC, you can see all the MVC projects have come up. Now here we have to select one of this, so which is we want using C#. So that is the language I'll be using. So I am selecting this template which supports C# language. The rest you can see that this is F#, and this is a API project which is also F#. So but this is the C# one. So I have now selected it. Click on next. Here give a name. So for this project, so I'll say first MVC web app. Okay, give your folder. My folder is this default, and the solution name, so whatever name you want to give it, so it will take the default name, whatever the project name is, but you can change it if you want to. Now click on next button. So this is .NET 6, as I said. So they are all this is the latest one, which is the full one available. .NET 7 preview is available, but the full one is still not out. So this is the .NET 6 which is supported by Microsoft. So you can use this framework. You can leave rest of the things as it is. This is HTTPS, this is Docker, but there is no need to change anything for your first project. Click on create button and now this will create a standard application with the default pages, libraries and default values. Okay, so you can see that the folder structure is organized in this way, where you have so the controllers, models and views. So that is why it is MVC, which is models, views and controllers. So model is what provides the data. Views is what you will basically so that will be used to present something to the user. So that is the UI which you will see, the user interface. That is the view. And then the controller is the one which coordinates between the model and the view. So whatever data the model has, controller's responsibility is to pass that data to the view. So by default, you can see that there is a home controller on the right hand side. And so this is the code for that. If you go down, you can see there are different methods. These are called as action methods. Okay. The return type is iAction result. And now you can see that these are empty. So you can return an empty view, which means you will have a corresponding view here. So if you go, so like index is the action method. Home is the controller. This is the home controller. So there will be a folder inside views called as home. And if you go inside that, you will find an index page, which is a view. So when you go here to the controller and say that, okay, return this view. So the runtime will search for that view in this location, and it will find this, once it finds this index view, it will render that view. Okay. So that is the instruction we are giving, to the compiler or to the runtime. Yeah. Similarly here, privacy, you can find one privacy here view. Similarly, you can see that there are some shared components which are used in all the views, like the top menu, and that code is there here. There are CSS files, there are other validation scripts, all these things are here. So let's go to some other folders. You can see that there is a www root folder, and here this folder is basically what contains all the CSS JavaScript library files. So there will be some bootstrap, some jQuery files. So all these files will be in the www root. Similarly, there is a JSON file here, which is basically a configuration file where you can store some config information. There is a program.cs where you can specify if you want a different routing. So you can specify those patterns here. And this is basically what gets executed first when you run the application. This gets executed, and then it asks the app to run. And after that, your pages will be rendered. Okay, so the controller will be called and the pages will be rendered. Similarly, there is a properties here, a launch settings. So here you can also set certain values. If you want to use different development environment, different browsers, different URLs, you can set all those things here. Then you have dependencies where you have the frameworks that is used, which are basically, again, some assembly files. You can add your own packages using the NuGet package. For that, you have to right click this dependencies, and you can go to this manage NuGet packages, and then you can add your own packages. So you can go here, go to browse, and it will refresh, it will come up with all these packages that are available. You can select whatever package you want. For example, entity framework is there. If you want to use entity framework to call some database objects, so you can use entity framework for that. For any entity management, you have packages. So like this, there are different packages for Azure blobs. So these packages are available. You can add it, and those DLLs will be added here. Okay. So now what we can do is we can run this application and see what happens, right? So first, when you click on this button, it will run, it will build and run the application. You can also build it, or if you want, you can just build the solution like this. Okay, now you can see the status here on the bottom left corner here. The status is build started, so which means it is compiling the code into a into some binaries, right? So it has to convert it to an intermediate language basically, and there's that intermediate language will then convert to full machine code based on the type of machine you are using. So it will run to that machine code. That will happen during the runtime, so when you run the application. Now let's run the application. So you can see here the default page has come up, and as I said, so there is a layout page which is used to render the menu items. You can go to the layout page, and you can see that the menu items are there. So this is the share. So inside views, share, layout. So all these menu items are like first MVC web app. So you can see this is the name. So and then these menu items are there, home and privacy. I can make it something like MySpace. Privacy. You can say, okay, terms. Save it. This is a hot reload feature in Visual Studio 2022. You can click on that. It should refresh this page when I do that, and it will update these menu items. So now you can see that the menu items got updated. So MySpace terms. So this is where how you have to do it. Now let's do something more. Now you have this this index action methods. So as I said that you can pass an empty view, or you can pass a model through the view, like this error model example here. So it passes a model. Okay, so the models are defined here. Like it has defined an error view model. You can pass this model. So this model will contain a request ID. So there are two properties, request ID and so request ID. So those two things are passed. So let's create a model of our own. So add, right click, and then add, select class, and then give your class a name. Let's say call it student. Add. So now student has been added. Let's add some properties. So name, and then let's add public string city. So these are the three properties in our student model object. So what I will do is I can go to this controller here, and I will add a model object here. Okay, so in the index, I can say student. Student, and then set the values here. Okay, so like student dot name equal to Sejon dot city equal to New York. Okay. So now this is the student model. Now what I want to do is I want to pass it to a view, right? So I can pass it like this object. So now this student so this view will render the model properties, but I have to then do some additional things which I am going to do now. So for that, let's go to this error view model and to the error view here, and then see what they have done. So that way you will be able to understand it better. So you can see that they have set the title here by default. These are the things Core provided by Microsoft. So one is a title, which is a good thing. So you can set your title as well. Then there is some HTML code, and then there is a condition here, and based on that, the request ID is shown. And then on top you can see that model is error view model, so they're specifying this, right? Model is error view model. So we can also do like this. So what you can do is copy it, go to index. You can see that there is no model specified. Now I'm going to specify a model, and my model name is student. So now I should be able to render these values. Okay, so here you can see that they are using this at the rate. That is the convention where you can write code. Okay, you can write code inside this kind of brackets, or you can directly call the model like this also, like this. Okay, so if you go here, let's add some HTML code here. So model dot name, and then I'll say I live in model dot city. Okay, very simple code. So what I'm basically saying, what I'm doing here is that I'm just retrieving, calling these properties. These property values I have already set in the controller. Here, so whatever property values I have set, I am passing this object to the view. Now the view is getting this getting access to that model object, and so, and then once it gets access to this model object using this model this keyword, then you can access the properties of that, right? And how does it knows that this is the model it has to use? Because I have specified here, okay, at model is student, which means whenever you use this keyword at model, so it knows that it has to use the student object which we have created in the controller. Okay, and then it accesses this properties, and it should display these values, right? So let's run it and see whether it works or not. Okay, so now you can see that whatever code we have written, so that code, so my name is John, I live in New York. So this is what we have set in the controller, and you can see that these values are now coming up here, right? So you can see this. So that is how you use the model view controller. So this is a very basic app which I have created for first time users. But if you want to do more, there are a lot of things you can do. You can add more projects to this solution. You can retrieve data from database, populate the model, and then pass those models to the appropriate controllers, and then from the controllers to the view. So you can do all those things which can be done at a when once you learn the basics. There are other videos also which I have created. If you're interested, you can browse and go through those videos. And I'll also request you to please like and subscribe to my channel so that you can get regular updates whenever I come up with new videos. Thanks a lot for watching.